with the 50th example and it said that a solid body starts rotating about a stationary axis with beta is equal to beta naught cos phi, where beta naught is a constant and phi is the angular position at any time t. Okay, from angular velocity of a body as a function phi. So now we know that angular acceleration is derivative of angular velocity with respect to time, but as it is given as a function of phi, so in this case I will multiply it with multiply and divide by d phi. So on multiply and divide by d phi, I can write this d phi by dt is omega into d omega by d phi is equal to beta naught into cos phi. So omega into d omega will be equal to beta naught cos phi into d phi, and then I will say integrating on both sides, where initial omega is 0 and the omega is a function of this, where initial angular position is 0 and angular position at any instant is phi. So the integration of omega will be omega square by 2 beta naught as it is. The integration of cos phi will be sin phi, limit varies from 0 to phi, and here also the limit varies from 0 to omega. So it will be omega square by 2 is equal to beta naught into sin phi upper limit minus lower limit is 0. So omega is equal to 2 beta naught into sin phi in the root. This is omega as a function of phi. So that's the omega, which is a function of phi. Now we need to plot this graph. So we can also plot this taking the standard values of phi as 0, 0, 90, 0, 90, 180, 370, 270 and 360. So omega will be equal to sin 0 is 0. Under root of 2 beta naught, okay, sin pi is 0, sin 3 pi by 2 is minus 1, so omega will be not defined, and sin 2 pi would be 0. So now you can plot the dependency of omega versus phi using this. Okay, thank you.